Just the way you were able to win that game the other night, where they kind of cut it down, double digit lead down to about six, and then you were able to put it away. How much does that encourage you, just the way you're able to close a team out?
Yeah, it was huge for us. I mean, we've worked a lot. We've worked really hard at finishing the game. And I thought we really showed resilience. They cut it to six, and I think we stepped up our defense, and we got a stop, and then Andrea got it and went down and scored a layup. But it was huge for us, and it gave us some momentum, it gave us some energy, and it gave us some confidence. So I was really, really proud of how we finished the game.
What's the difference in this South Carolina team versus the one you faced a couple times last year?
Yeah, I think they got more experience. They've been in tougher games. You're taking Asia Wilson, who's a freshman, and now she's a sophomore. Tiffany is Mitchell's more. They just got more experience, and they're playing with a lot of confidence. And I think it starts with Dawn and what she instills in them, and they're just getting the job done.
What do you need to see from Courtney Dunbar? How do you want to use her? I mean, what's kind of the plan for her?
Well, Courtney, we got to continue to get her steady on the defensive end and rebound. And I think she's done a great job. She's come a long way. We need her in the game offensively, and I think she's really done a good job of not. If we talk about her being able to play on both ends of the floor, and I think she now is proving that she can do that.
What's Alexa's status for tomorrow?
You know, I'm not sure. I think she's better, but I don't. I think it's kind of game time situation.
Holly, what have been the biggest challenges for you as a coach in terms of getting this team to play consistently, to get them to where you want them to be? I mean, you've made some strides,
yeah,
but yet still from game to game, it's almost like you have to take role, or some things go well, some things don't go
well. Yeah, I think, Dan, we're still trying to find ourselves. I think we're playing a lot better together, and I think it's coming with time. This team is, you look at the games we've lost, and we've been into games, and we've had opportunities to win, and we just couldn't finish the deal. And I think now, the more we've practiced, the more we've been around each other, the more set people who we put with each other, it's made a big difference. So I just think we just keep staying the course, trying to prepare them, putting them in situations like the games, and practicing them, understanding what we need to do.
Are there things now, have you had enough of an experience with them that when you go into a game, you think, well, I got to watch this or I got to watch that in terms of trying to get the best out of them?
I think combinations is huge for us at certain times in the game. I think when we start sputtering, I think the ball gets stuck in our hands. And when the ball gets stuck in our hands, then we've got to do something different, because we're a really, really good team when we move the ball, pass and cut, and play the game. And when the ball gets stuck in our hands, we tend to stand, and that's kind of where we go a little haywire.
Holly, given the size of South Carolina and the way Bashara played at Vanderbilt, do you consider getting her back in the starting lineup Monday?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm not sure what we're going to do, but Bashara's going to play a lot of minutes. I promise you that.
No matter what happens tomorrow, South Carolina's a pretty commanding lead in the league standings.
Yeah.
What do y'all do in terms of setting those goals for the rest of the season? A top four seed in the SEC tournament, top four in the NCAA, or what are you kind of looking at?
Well, we're going to take it one step at a time. We want to be in the top four in the SEC, and we want to keep grinding it out and winning our next game and our next game and our next game. So our goals are to win on out. And when you do that, I think you take care of hopefully getting into the top four seeds. So that's our goal.
Are you happy with Jamie's play and where her arrow looks like it's really pointing up in Thursday?
I love how Jamie's playing. I think Jamie's a couple things. Her defense has gotten more solid, and she's more aggressive. When Jamie's aggressive and attacks the basket and plays under control, she's pretty darn good, and I think she's gotten confidence. She's gotten in the gym and shoots extra, and there's something to be said, and she's built her confidence up. So I love what she's doing right now. She's in an attack mode, and that's what we need her to be.
Now, with those pull-up jumpers that she hit Thursday, is that an adjustment over those crazy drives she used to make earlier in the year? I mean, is that?
We're just trying to get her to play on balance, and when Jamie plays on balance, she's going to hit majority of her shots. And so when she goes in off balance, it's the degree of difficulty is really, really high. But when she comes in under control, She got a great shot, and I trust her to shoot that mid-range jumper. That's what she needs to do.
You shortened the bench a little bit on Thursday. Is that kind of what you think you might do?
Well, I think a little bit, but I think it's kind of been the flow of that game, Dan, and what we needed to do. I think we've had a great couple of days of everybody. It's probably Mimi Jackson's best practice the whole year. So I think it just depends on the situation and the time to give them opportunities. But if we have to shorten the bench, we will. And I thought Vanderbilt, we had to shorten our bench because of just how the game flow and how it was going. It's kind of a feel for me.
Holly, what are the things that South Carolina does best?
They're athletic. They're physical. They play hard every possession. They've got a great front line in Coates and Wilson, and I think they play around them. Here you have Tiffany Mitchell, but in my opinion, I think Tiffany's the third option after those two players. I just think they play well together. And when you play well together and you play hard, great things happen.
Those players with Coates and Wilson.
Yes. Yeah.